Hello, beautiful creature. Welcome back to Trend Report, where we're going to talk about all things trending. The first trend I want to spotlight is the oil slick hair trend. Iridescent, ethereal, multi-dimensional colors. This is a new type of hair color to play with. I think the oil slick trend is a great way to experiment with color without being overwhelmed by colors, because when you see it right away, you don't really see the colors. It's pretty subtle, but under certain lighting, you can see the facets. You can start picking up on the different color tonalities and changes, and it makes people look again. I have to hand it to Guy Tang. He transformed my hair. Came in looking really ratchet, and I came out feeling like a majestic dark unicorn. Thank you, Guy. I love you. Check out his work. I'm gonna add his stuff right here so you can see how incredible he is. He's a hair artist. I mean, it's remarkable how talented he is. If you want to play with more hair color trends, guys, the oil slick hair is here. Braids are going to be a huge hair trend this year. Every time I go on Instagram, every time I go online, I'm seeing at least one celebrity girl, one famous Instagram girl, one popular fashion blogger rocking braids. You have the normal French braids, the Dutch braids, backwards Dutch braids, backwards forward. I mean, everyone's just coming up with different combinations of all of these beautiful braids. It gets the hair out of your face, you get to see more of your face, and it creates a beautiful type of shape to your head. And how the braids look, it's so intricate and beautiful, and I've always had this fascination of intricate looking things when they're knotted. So huge fan of this trend, I love it.
You can use your lipstick as eyeliner. I know it's off label, but makeup is not about rules, it's about options. Experimenting with your liquid lipstick as eyeliner can bring a fresh change to your routine. You can easily create ombre looks, and depending on the formula, you can get a beautiful matte liner look. With so many fun, exciting beauty innovations, peel-off makeup is the newest trend. Imagine getting long-lasting brows or stained lips that will last for a couple of days. It uses familiar ingredients that's derived from sunless tanning technology. Voila, hello tinted makeup. This year, you might be seeing people sporting the no bra bras, and these bras usually have see-through portions with designs or embellishments, so they're great for layering. Wear it under sheer tops or tanks for that sexy peekaboo style. That's right, light up shoes. For all you 90s kids, this is major throwback. Adult kids can still rock these to late night music festivals or concerts. It also adds a cool futuristic vibe to the on-trend sport leisure look. Alternative bodysuits lets you go backless without having straps to keep it together. Most are form-fitting, so it hugs all your body in beautiful curves. It's basically like an updated tank top, but with cutouts. You can have more variety with bodysuits because they can be dressed up or down effortlessly.
When you're wearing a bodysuit, you have more options to layer on things. You can layer on a skirt, form-fitting pants. You could layer on different options of tops. I mean, there's so many ways for you to customize your look, and a bodysuit provides a great base because it's form-fitting, it gives you a nice silhouette to work with, and you can start layering things on top of it. Chokers are still here to stay, but it's getting a little bit of a revamp. So there's a lot of other brands that are making more elaborate, more regal, majestic looking chokers. And one of my favorite brands is by Dynasty. They are a brand that's all about Chinese Asian aesthetic. They found a really cool balance of East meets the West, and it gives a very regal look. So this is one choker that I'm wearing from Dynasty, which I really love. It's inspired by those Mandarin collars that you see. So if you're looking for a very special choker, you gotta go online or shop local, or you can make your own. Have you ever tried to take a selfie and you ended up with bad lighting? Boo-hoo, first world problems, right? Someone has solved this problem, and they invented this phone case that lights up. It's called the Lumi case. Once you put it on, it looks like this. It's a pretty standard case. It's not that exciting looking, but this is where the magic happens. You press this button in the back, and it turns on this light. And if you hold it, you can illuminate more, or you can dim it back down. So if you are looking to like upgrade your selfie game, or maybe you do live streaming and you require decent lighting for the face, I think this is a very interesting way to just light yourself without having to rely on good lighting on location, so you will always have good lighting with a case like this. Man, does this upgrade your selfie. I mean, it really does look pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. FYI, I was not paid or sponsored by any of these brands to recommend or to push or to talk about their products. I'm just reporting things that I see are popular online just so that you guys can know, hence Trend Report. Here are some app recommendations that are either fun to try or that can unleash your creativity. I'm sure you guys have heard of Masquerade. This app is super fun. It's essentially a face recognition app where you can pretty much be anyone. You can be Leonardo DiCaprio, you can be Snoop Dogg, you can be a bunny, a cat, whatever it is you've always wanted to be, you can be, thanks to this app. I know Snapchat is also playing with a really cool mask that you can wear. So Snapchat and Masquerade, if you're looking to just have fun with your selfies and just send someone a laugh, these are some really cool apps that you can play around with. I know a lot of people are looking to upgrade and revamp their Instagram feed. However, it could be a little difficult just because when you're trying to build a feed, you have to preview everything. So if you're looking for a really cool preview app, you can check out Snug. This app allows you to preview your Instagram feed before posting online. So you can go in, experiment, and if you love what you see, post it. If you don't, delete it and start all over and start building your feed, making it more coherent and giving it more of that storytelling edge. Tax season is upon us, yay, taxes. No jumping up, okay, me neither, yay, blah. But you want it to be easy, you want it to be effortless, and you want to save as much as you can. TurboTax and MyBlock will help provide really good resources for your taxes. Before social media and the internet, if people wanted to sell their clothes, they would either do garage sales, yard sales, or they would go to a consignment shop, sell their clothes, and the consignment shop would resell it. Fast forward to today, thanks to smartphones and Wi-Fi, you can start selling your clothes online via mobile. So there's two apps you can use to sell and buy your clothes. One is called Poshmark and the other is called Tradesy. They're essentially consignment networks where you can sell and trade your own clothes, so you get more options to play with. This is a great way to get rid of your clothes and make a little bit of money, but also give it to a good home and getting a chance to find a really cool piece for your own closet. Some of my favorite pieces that I've bought and I still keep till this day are pieces I've purchased from consignment shops and thrift shopping.
Digital doodles can bring fun elements of art on your Instagram photos. It adds a personal touch to your photos. You can do it on your own on Photoshop, Procreate, or with Pixelmator.
So I have something exciting to share from my end. My new webcomic, Helios Femina, is out and available for free on Webtoons. New chapters will be released every Sunday, so I'll see you there. So I have my March Ipsy bag and I'm gonna show you what I got. First product I have here is the Knots 28 Remedy Balancing Toner. What I like about this balancing toner is that it helps brighten the skin and it also helps reduce any fine lines you have around your mouth and your eye area. And it feels really light and refreshing. So right after you clean your face, you want to apply this toner on right away, and then you can layer on a moisturizer on top. So a moisturizer that I wanted to talk about, because I've always loved this brand, is it's called Goat's Milk. This goat milk is incredible because I live in LA, so my skin gets really dry because there's no rain here. So I'm used to like a more humid climate. This Goat's Milk product, so I'm gonna show you. It has a very whipped, airy texture, and when you apply it on, it doesn't feel heavy at all. It's like whipped cream, it just disappears, but your skin feels really moisturized and hydrated. So I'm really excited that we're sampling them in our Ipsy bag. You guys know how much I love my hair oils because I'm always coloring my hair and the ends get kind of sad and damaged and it's practically like dead ends. I always try my best to be conscious about repairing my ends and adding leave-in conditioner, oils, and there's one that I really love, it's by Marc Anthony. Not the singer, the hair guy. And the product that I really love from theirs is their Argan Oil line. This is their perfect blow-dry smoothing cream where it guarantees 3 days of smooth, blown-out hair that just looks beautiful, it looks fresh, it smells fresh, and it also helps reduce any of the heat damage. You wanna use this product while your hair is still damp, applying, I wouldn't apply it at the roots because you don't really need it at the roots, but unless you have really, really curly hair, then I would. But because I don't have curly hair, I like to apply it along my mid to the ends of my hair. And then afterwards, I let it soak in. then I start blow drying and styling and curling, and my hair will stay like this for a week. I know that sounds kind of gross and grody, but dry shampoo, and that's really all where it's at. Like, all of the gunk is really at the scalp. So once you keep that clean, the rest of your hair is pretty clean. And the last product is this nail file by Margaret Dabbs. It's essentially a two-in-one. You can file your nails and you can buff it on the other side. So I like to file on the harder side, and then I flip it over and I polish it by buffing everything out, and I get super shiny nails. So I wanna end my trend report by showing you some really cool Instagram accounts to follow. So we're gonna head over to the Gram Gallery. Let's go. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you were inspired, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye.